Our next layer here is the ETS rater. If I click on that, you can see here's our ETS comments, these purple ones and these purple highlights. You can see it's checking for grammar, mechanics, style, and usage and spelling. And it gives us a list of each item that it's found. If I don't want these checking for grammar, I can uncheck it and they'll drop off the page. If I find that I don't agree with this or with this comment, I can click on it and I can click dismiss and it will drop off completely and the student won't see it. So it's up to you if you'd like to have E-Rater on at all when you're creating your assignment. On a global assignment level, you can turn that off. Oops. I'm sorry about that. You can turn that off on the global assignment level, or you can leave them on and turn them off on an individual basis. Another item that's really great about the E-Rater for the student side, when they click on one of these items, you can see it gives them a handbook. So if they click on View Handbook, it's actually going to take them to an online handbook with better explanations of why they're getting those type of comments. You can see the table of contents is quite large, so they can run through these items whenever they want to. And they got to that by just clicking on the actual comment itself, which a student will do on their site, and they can click View Handbook.